Okay, so most of this we shaped out on the belt sander. Unfortunately, the phone stopped recording for some reason, don't know why, but we still have a little bit of a line here to clean up, so we'll go ahead and do that. And we've got machinery running, so it's gonna get noisy. This is a killer file. Both the edges are safe or dead or floating edges, you can call it. You can buy them this way or you can grind them down, sand them down yourself. That way you have a safe edge. So what I'm doing is holding it flat against the stummel going down, so this isn't going to cut into the shank, and I could do it the other way also and not cut into the bowl. cabinet scraper, you can buy them cheap, profile them any way you want. And you can see the instructional videos on YouTube how to sharpen the edges. What you're looking for is a burr. So what I'm doing here is riding it smooth on the shank to catch the outline. So I'm just peeling off that high portion right there. So I don't have to remove it all at once. shank is tapered, down. So once we get that, all we're doing, it by hand. So we're looking at every angle. When I'm sanding, I'm trying to keep the angle of the bowl and not put a whole lot of pressure. Run it down to the shank. And then typically what you'll get is a bulge here or a bulge here. So what I'm doing is keeping the sandpaper watching this line, putting it at an angle and not putting any pressure here. All we're doing is blending. You know, trying to give it the illusion of symmetry. Human eye is pretty good at detecting variances. I don't remember exactly what the number is, but the human eye can see very small. Just what I can see. So I think it's just practice. Learning the muscle memory, developing your eye. When I pull down the shank, I'm watching the line on the bowl there, so I'm trying to maintain that line, and then we're going at an angle. You can do this by putting it in a post and a vise and using a strip sandpaper and sanding down this way and this way, and that'll even out that transition there, so, or blend it, and that's probably what we're going to do next. But that excess wood is off, and we've got our transition. So what I'll do now is I'll put it on a dowel, put it in the vise, and I'll do the sandpaper, rolling it back and forth and just blending. I'll tape off the cap that hasn't completely set up yet. And so someone, you were asking about how I do the transitions. That's